Welcome to the 21st century. Today we are going to introduce you to the Common Core.
What the heck is that? I teach history. That is not what I teach. I'm a historian.
Our students have not learned to read, write, and think to be successful in college and careers. Students leaving our campus are not ready for the real world.
You mean my students are not reading on the proper grade level? It's not my problem, that was their middle school English teacher's job. You know, my kids did come from Wilson.
No, now it is all of our jobs. We are here to make sure our kids succeed at any cost, and the state is telling us we must raise the rigor.
Oh great, something else extra I have to do. Not that I really will anyway.
But wait, you are already doing a lot of it. Your students read, write, and think already. Now we need to use what we're already doing more effectively and cooperatively.
So I have to work with science and math now? Those subjects aren't as important as history.
Maybe not. But we have to work together to help everyone out. We teach our own content, but a lot of the strategies we use in our content areas are the same.
That is not true. How my students read and write in my subject is not the same way they read and write in your content area.
Your students will still learn your content, but all content areas will focus on argumentation to raise the rigor. Students will see how all content areas use this common strategy.
So we'll all work together through our content areas to help all students become better thinkers, readers, and writers?
Yes. Leaders in each content area have been trained in the Common Core and will help you see how you can more effectively use what you are already doing.
Cool, I'm in. So my content area will work with math, science, English, CTE, P, foreign language, fine arts, and the whole school to raise the rigor.
Great, Mr. History. You're starting to see how the Common Core will help your students in every subject. Because if you don't, then you'll be history.